You grew up on Paul Band. How big is your reserve?
8 by 8, I believe. Not a very big reserve.
Uh-huh.
There's a lake out there. You know. there's a lake out there called Wabaman.
Uh-huh.
And we grew up around the lake area because that's where all the food that we need was fish, duck eggs, ducks, muskrats, beaver, everything that we need to eat.
Making me hungry.
Yeah, me too. cooking muskrat tails on the stove. We grew up in something like this. How we're sitting right now, how this teepee is behind me. We grew up eating nothing but traditional food.
Mm-hmm.
We traveled for about 2-3 days before we can get to our hunting area where the men were supposed to hunt. And then we'd stay there, and ladies would dry the meat and to preserve it, like, you know, keep it for the winter. Dry berries, Saskatoons, mostly Saskatoons, crushed choke cherries, played in a creek, and our mother would be out gone snaring rabbits or trying to shoot a chicken or get us something to eat, and us kids would... We were taught to be responsible at a really young age.
Mm-hmm.
5-6 year old, you were already told a lot of things, a lot of the life that you're going to live for the rest of your life. They taught us responsibility, hauling wood, baking bannock, and it was only a big one-room cabin and an upstairs, but we all lived downstairs, especially in the winter. It's too cold. Wooden fire stove, no propane, no nothing. I started school when I was 9 year old.
Was it like a residential school or anything like that?
No. No? We had to walk to school every day.
Uh-huh.
Walk to school or ride horses. When it's like this, we'd ride horses in a fall time like this. In the winter, we had to walk.
Uh-huh. So did you guys ever come to the city much?
No, we didn't know what the city was then.
Even though it was right there, Edmonton?
Yeah, we didn't know. We didn't know the city at all. Uh-huh. We were just little country kids. We didn't know anything outside of our reservation.
Mm-hmm.